Hello students, welcome to the session. In previous session we have discussed about modules and after that we had continued towards the test bench. For understanding the next topics, it is very important to understand the basics what we are studying now. This is our fifth session and today we are going to discuss about the basics which are very much essential in this subject. Because this subject is basically related to programming. It is a hardware description language. For that, we must know the do's and don'ts. We must know the syntaxes. We must know the rules. We must know the procedures which we need to follow while performing the programs. So in programs, there are two parts. One is module. In module, we have discussed the structure of module. Module is a keyword, like in VHDL we use entity and in C language we start with hash include files in the similar way in Verilog we use module. In module and add module we write our entire program. So we have to give one module name, suppose my CIR, the short form of my circuit, is the name of my particular program. My project is having three inputs, A, B and C, and there is one output, that is D. But with this block diagram, we are not able to judge what is there inside this particular block diagram. So there may be few gates, there may be combination of various gates. So one such possible combination is that there is one AND gate called as G1 and there is another OR gate called as G2. A and B inputs are directly given to G1 and C is given to D, that is OR gate. So this is inside this particular block diagram. Block diagram shows us only inputs and the outputs. So whatever is visible from the block diagram will be declaration inside module. So we can see only input A, input B, input C and output D. So that will be part of this particular module. What is not visible? The connection between AND gate and OR gate is not visible. We will define it as wire. All the intermediate stages which are not visible in block diagram but they exist inside and we must know their status to get the proper logic level of the output, we have to define them separately by a keyword wire. We are defining wire and we are giving a name W1. So what is inside my program? It is AND gate. AND is gate 1, that is G1, we can see here. So G1 having output W1 and inputs A and B. So inside that first we write output. Output is W1 and followed by inputs. Inputs are A and B. So here we understand that AND is a keyword. So AND operation of the inputs AB and its output should go to W1. Similarly for OR gate, one input is C and one input is W1, that is W1 comma C, and the output is D, that is written here. So here we are defining the AND gate and its connection. Here our module ends. We have defined everything which is present inside my circuit. This is module. But module writing is not the only part which we require in Verilog. Along with module, we must define a test bench. Test bench is something which gives clear idea about the waveforms, when to start waveform and how to declare the waveform. So once we have initialized the module, we have to write a program for test bench. In test bench, there will be two parts. One is stimulus. In stimulus, we will assign the values and delays. And in response, we will check its result on the display or monitor. Like on a screen of our monitor, we will be able to see the various waveforms. Here we will have the digital waveforms, say 1 0 1 0, like that. So we have to stimulus. In stimulus, we will give the input values, when my signal is starting, what is the status, whether it is binary, hexadecimal or any other type. Then we will get some response. In between that, again we will have the module of inputs and outputs. So let us check how it happens. So this is one general structure of test bench, where we have module. We are giving one module name. Here we have to define inputs in terms of registers. This is a data type where we can store the data. Along with registers, we use wire, which will define the outputs. Now wire is also used in the module. That wire and this wire are different. We should not get confused between them. The wire which we used in the module was defining the intermediate wire, a wire connection between, say, two different gates connected inside a circuit. In test bench, wire means it will define the outputs. Then next stage is our instantiation of module under test. This is the name which is under test. There will be our port names, what are the ports of inputs and outputs. Then we have to use a keyword called as initial. We use it two times. Initial for stimulus, here we will declare the values of our waveform. And second time, we will check the response, that is the output. So these are the initial, both of them are keywords. All blue text are the keywords in this particular example. First we will go for stimulus declaration, and then we have to check the response declaration. Let us see how we get that. So say registers are inputs, wires are outputs. This is our module under test, initial and module. This is general structure of test bench. Now what happens inside initial? We have two initials. First initial, we will define the values of our waveform, which is nothing but our input. So here we will consider this example where we have three inputs A, B, C and output is D. So my inputs are A, B, C. I am defining with REG register, and output is D. So we are defining it as wire. So wire is D. These are our declaration of stimulus and response. Stimulus are the inputs and responses are the outputs. Then this is our my circuit, the port declaration in brackets A, B, C, D. All the inputs and output. First we are writing inputs, then followed by output. Then first initial, where we are going to declare the stimulus. It will attach between begin and end. We will begin our value declaration and we will end it. So what are other things inside? Say we have A, B and C, three inputs. First is say A, second input is B and third input is C. So we have to define, we have to tell the system what these A, B and C are going to do. So it reads as we are having one bit. The small b stands for binary and this zero stands for the logic 0. That means we are using 1 bit binary whose value is 0. So at present it is at 0 level. Who is at 0 level? A. Say this is our A at 0 level. Then B is 1 bit binary and its logic is 1. Say here we will write B. Its waveform will start say from 1. Then C is also defined as at 1, then it is say at 1. Then after 100 gap, this hash is representing delay. After delay of 100, It may be nanosecond. We have to define it in nanosecond, picoseconds or seconds. Then A will be A dash B1. Then B will be 1 bit, B0. So what is the change in A after 100 nanosecond? So once 100 nanosecond are passed, then this A will become 0. Earlier it was 0. Then next it is becoming 1 after 100 nanoseconds. So it will go to 1. Then what is happening with B after 100 nanoseconds? B is becoming, say, 0. So B is at 1 after 100 nanoseconds. It will go to 0. Then C is going to 1. C is already 1. And after simulation also it is 1. So there won't be any change. So it will go straight at 1 level. So at this point, this is 0. This is 1. This is 1. Then after that, this is 1. This one is 0. And C is 1. Like this, we have to understand the waveform. Then this is stimulus declaration. The next initial will tell the system to show waveform on the output. So dollar monitor is our output keyword where we are defining time dollar time, where A is equal to percentage B, B is equal to percentage B, C is also equal to percentage B, and D is also percentage B, comma A, comma B, comma C, comma D. You must connect this with the C language output printf command. Percentage B stands for the binary. If our values are hexadecimal, what we have to write here? We have to write percentage H. So as all the inputs are binary, either its value will be 0 or 1, we are using percentage. So the monitor will tell the system that A, B, C and D have to be shown on the display where all of them are binary values. These are about this test bench, initial stimulus and initial declaration condition. Now we will understand in more detail what are the other declarations we can see, what are the delay types, what are the other parameters, what are the numbers we can use in Verilog, or what are the data types. So let us discuss them. After that again we will come back to this particular test bench example. So let us start with the Verilog basics. First, say comments. Comments are very important part of any programming language. For example, whenever we write a program, we need to give some information to other reader. Suppose I am writing a program and I am giving it to you. Then you must know what I am intending from my particular syntax or that particular line. Then what I will do? I will write a comment after that particular statement, that this line is telling the system that this is my AND gate connected to particular OR gate. So for writing comments, there is a similar way like C++. Like we can use double hash for a single line comment, or we can use hash star star hash for a multiple comment. So these are about the comments. Then punctuation. Like when we end a syntax, we have to use a semicolon. If we forget semicolon, we will get an error. So semicolon is punctuation. Like C++, Verilog is also case sensitive. We have to remember it. Then identifiers. Identifier is usually a variable. We will discuss about the variable. Variables come under the data types. We can use any letter, digit, the underscore or dollar as an identifier. Identifier is nothing but you will identify our value. So they can begin with these things, but they cannot begin with digits, right? And it is as in C++, variable name should not be chosen to assist in documentation. We cannot use the keywords as our identifiers. If something is already defined, like module is defined, it is a keyword. Initial is a keyword, and or not, these are keywords, so we cannot use them as identifier. We have to choose some other name. Then signal values. four possible values we can use. Either we can use 0, 1, x or z. 0 means logic 0, 1 means logic 1. If something is a don't care condition or unknown condition, then we can use x, capital X or small x, right? So these are don't care or unknown condition. There is another fourth condition we can use for impedance, capital Z or small z. It gives high impedance tri-state. Many places we require to define the impedances, so at that time we can use Z. So these signal values we can use. Parameters. A parameter in a Verilog can be any Verilog constant. So we may have variables, we may have constants. So parameters are used for a generalized design. Suppose I am talking about a 4-bit adder. So rather than making 4-bit adder, I can make an n-bit adder. So user can define, okay, if I am making a program for n-bit adder, you can choose whether I am making 3-bit adder, 4-bit adder or multiple bit adder. In memory, like any system, we require memory. Here also memory is very important. A Verilog allows two-dimensional array, which typically get used memory spaces. Like registers. What is register? Register stores value, like flip-flop. All of us know about flip-flop. Flip-flop are used to store, say, 1 bit. What is this? This one is register, 7 down 0. That means he can store 8 bits. Similarly, one memory array, 63 down 0, can have 64 8 bits. So when we combinely write register 7 down 0 with for memory 63 down 0, that means it consists 64 8 bit words. Like this, we can have various combinations for memory. Then numbers. Numbers in Verilog. Numbers will have a particular format. In the test bench, we have seen binary. Usually, whenever we deal with zeros and ones, we use binary. So binary we can define with small b or capital B. What we have to remember here while programming for not getting error, you can observe this small dash, right? So this overhead dash we must include for declaring any number. So if it is binary, we have to use this dash small b or capital B. Then next, we can use hexadecimal numbers, small h or capital H, decimal, small d or capital D, of course with this tag of dash, or octal, small o or capital O. We should not get confused between 0 and O. Sometimes we type 0 and we get error in place of O, we have to write O. And these numbers can be strings or digits. Say we can use numbers from 0 to 9. Say capital A to F, small a to F, small x, capital X, small z, capital Z. X means unknown. Z means high impedance. Now these numbers can also have a fixed pattern to define. Like numbers can have unsized or sized constant number. So for example, this first example says 659 is a decimal number. It is a fixed decimal number. Then say dash h 837ff. This is a hexadecimal number. O 7460 is an octal number. But if we don't define the particular type of our number format, then we will get error. It will be illegal, like 4af. It is not giving any clarity whether it is, because f belongs to hexadecimal, but hexadecimal is not mentioned here. Then sized constant numbers. Here we can define a size before that particular definition of number. Suppose this is binary. So what I am saying, 4-b, that means 4-bit binary number. If I write 1-b, that means 1-bit binary number. And what is that binary number? 1001. Similarly, 5-D3, that means 3 is decimal number, a 5-bit decimal number. 3-b, 3-bit number with the least significant bit unknown. Here we are using X. It represents unknown. That is LHS. Least significant bit is unknown. Then here we have hexadecimal, which is unknown, which is 12 bit. Here 16 bit hexadecimal, which is impedance number. Like this, that represents impedance number. So we can use four basic values: 0, 1, x, and z. And 0 and 1 are also complement to each other. Complement means opposite of 0 is 1 and opposite of 1 is 0. Then we have to discuss the Verilog operators. Which operators are used in Verilog? We can use binary arithmetic operators, like say operator name, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus. Whenever we have to perform some arithmetic logic unit, we have to design ALUs, and we have to design various sections in our processor or system, then we have to use the mathematical operations and we have to represent them with some symbol. Addition is represented by plus sign, subtraction minus sign, multiplication star, division this slash, and modulus with this percent. We have to remember this while programming. We are going to use these operator names. Then there are relational operators. Relational operators will give the return value of true or false. For example, this is greater than. Greater than symbol is used to represent greater than. If A is greater than B, either it will be true or false. Then greater than or equal to, less than, less than or equal to. When we write double equal to, it is logical equality. They are logically equal. Suppose A double equal to B, that means I am saying that A is logically equal to B. Then if I am using exclamatory mark and followed by equal to, then it will be logically unequal. So we can define Verilog operators like this. So apart from that, we will have logical operators. Logical gates we can define. Logical operators operate on logical operands and return a logical value, that it will be true or false. So normally they used in if and while statements. We should not get confused with logical operators with bitwise Boolean operators. We will see next slide what are the bitwise operators. These are the logicals. They won't have a single bit. They will have more than one bit. So when I use exclamatory mark, it will show logical negation. Negation means negate. 0 to 1, 1 to 0. When I write double AND, it will be logical AND. When I use these two lines, it will be logical OR. So they are not single bit. There will be multiple bits. So say negate or this NOT gate. So if I say negate 5 equal to 6 is true. So that means what? The NOT of 5 is equal to 6. So like this we can understand the language of science. Science and symbols we must remember while operating in this Verilog. Bitwise operators, which are single bit. So single, this single dash, this wave, single wave symbol will be bitwise negate, not gate. Single AND, bitwise AND. Double AND, it's normal logical AND. It will have more than one bit. Single line, bitwise OR. Double lines, logical OR. This symbol for XOR. This wave AND, this is bitwise NAND. This negate straight line will call as bitwise NOR gate. This is equivalent bitwise NOT XOR. We'll remember them in more detail when we see the programming. But normally we have to remember that we have two type of gate symbols. One is logical and another one is bitwise. In logical we are using double, and for single bitwise we are using single lines. Then unary reduction operators. So we will use them in program for reduction. Say AND, this will AND. When we write like this, it will be AND reduction. This will be OR reduction. Similarly for XOR, NAND, NOR and XNOR, we will have the reduction operators. Then there will be conditional operators. These are operators like in C language what we use, like equal to, equal to, equal to. That means the case equality. The exclamatory mark equal to equality, equal to equal will give case inequality. If this parenthesis in brackets comma will give concatenation, then there will be left shift, right shift and a condition. Let us discuss them one by one. Say case equality. Case equality is the bitwise comparison which includes comparison of x and z values, and all the bits, if they match, they will return true. So case inequality will again, it will be comparison between x and z. The difference will produce inequality. The return value may be true or false. Concatenation will join two bits separated by comma. For example, A 0 comma B 1 down 7. That means there is a 0th bit of A will be added with 1 to 7 bits of B. Shift left, shifting operation. Say if I'm saying A is equal to A greater than 2. This will shift the value of A by 2 bits to the left. And whatever remaining is there towards right side, he will fill with the 0. Similarly, opposite will happen for shift right. And conditional. Conditional will give, its value will depend on the condition. It will assign some value. Suppose A is equal to C greater than D, question tag B plus 3 colon B minus 2. So what does that mean? It means if C is greater than D, then what we have to do? Then the value of A is B plus 3. Else value is B minus 2. It's a conditional case. Then the precedence of operators. There will be precedence. That means if we are using these operators in a line, if we are getting more than one operator, then we have to choose which one will be performed first and which one will be performed later. So this first line represents the highest precedence and the last one represents the lowest precedence. So if I get these symbols in particular line, then I have to choose with highest precedence first. Then Verilog data types. This we will discuss in continued session.